It's like from the day I was out of school. When we happened, it happened this past Friday. In the morning, and just before 10 in the morning. Just like right after, just after 9:45 it came. They came just at 10 o'clock. And in the morning, they were switching. They were switching at the North Southern Sea line. Right here. Just near downtown, Anderson. Prepared for Delta and South Carolina. Also guys, stay tuned, you'll see in a little bit. There was a part two for this. For the one at Delta also. That caught, but I wasn't able to do it outside because I was inside the local South, at the local South State Bank for a reason. But it was the same U18 thing. I think they were coming back from Honeypot on the same day as I recorded it. So I noticed the train calls that they were carrying the train calls that was heading for Anderson back to Delta. They were coming from Honeypot because they were sitting there for a couple weeks. And I go through about 1.5 hours away from school. And from home to school every day. Yeah, they used to be. They were not from CSX a long time ago. A very long time ago. For this direction. This train was heading for this road anyway. They were coming from the Pigeon Fairway maintenance yard, which is about, I think it's like 15 miles away from this direction. Somewhere along like that. It's like a 20-minute drive away from this direction from the direction to be for the maintenance yard. That's why it's actually near Homewood Park, just outside of Anderson. It's actually in Homewood, instead of Homewood, it's actually at Homewood Park, South Carolina.
There's multiple parts, by the way, guys.
One of the owners that works at this person was thinking I was podcasting outside, but I wasn't. And now that was the inside of that thrift store. This thrift store I go to every time. Which was where Gracie and I, with the video made Gracie was a few months ago. I'll still try to link the video in the description if I have time. There we
go. Let's stay tuned for tomorrow's video too.
Second, this was the part three of that story we were reading, and we would have almost got hit by the train. The train was really close to hitting us. Well, because we couldn't see it until we got into this, until we looked on the other side. And yeah, they were back, and they were going backwards once again. You can probably tell by the noise. Yeah, I can tell they're going backwards because of the way they're moving between the train cars. You can tell they're moving just like that right there. We were heading for a lost friend, but I was standing at the time. was Pat for this time in Belton, South Carolina. They were heading back for Anderson, South Carolina from Honeycutt. Well, these train cars were actually coming from Honeycutt. This was inside the Pat local staff station. I had to cash in some checks, yeah. They were going through that closed railroad crossing. Also realized part five, and this was a part five too. Well, the train was already gone 30 minutes later. They dropped off the engine before they left to go to Anderson's, yeah. You can see it right there. Right near Anderson's. Yeah, you can see all the tents were because they had a fall festival. In fact, today too.